Yemen and Afghanistan and Iraq. Let me hear you say Takbir, Allahu Akbar. Taking innocent human life is wrong. That's what we believe as Muslims. That's what Allah teaches us in Quran. Taking innocent human life is wrong, whether your name is George Bush, Barack Obama, or whatever those Chechen guys' names. It's a complicated name, I'm sorry. But whatever the name of a person is, if you kill innocent people, you are part of Hizbul Shaytan. You're not part of Hezbollah. You're not part of the party of God. I don't mean Hezbollah, the political. We're not talking about politics. We're talking about the Qulub, Ahlul Qulub. We need to be people of love, man. People of mercy. The messenger of God was a man of mercy. I've been blessed in my life by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's taken this fakir all over the earth, making people laugh in different parts of this planet. Different colors, different religions, different races, ethnicities, language, size, shape, gender, ages. And I'm here to tell you something. You guys want to hear it? You guys want to hear it?
Yes, sir.
Everybody on this earth is basically the same. I don't mean that as some kind of bumper sticker. Let me tell you what I mean. You are a bird in a cage. You are a bird before your cage. You're a bird inside your cage, and you will be a bird after the cage. But never forget, you are the bird, you are not the cage. The mistake we all make is thinking that the cage is the real you. No, 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 no. Everybody's cage is the same. Everybody's cage is arrogant. Everybody's cage has an ego. And the ego never wants to admit it's wrong. So that's why we always say stupid things. Let me tell you something. Everybody on this earth that I've ever met is the same because all of us are dumb. Let me tell you what I mean. We're all dumb in certain things. We don't know about certain things. We don't want to admit it. But all of us are dumb. Everybody has a friend who's really, really dumb. Every time you talk to your dumb friend, it reminds you how dumb you are. Because somehow it turns into a weird conversation. It's like a competition to out-dumb each other. You all have this experience, you're talking to your dumb friend, and you hear yourself in your own head like, stop talking. You're saying dumb things. That's another dumb thing right there. This happened to me recently. I was talking to a friend of mine, and he goes, sometimes you just gotta fight fire with fire. I was like, what? Sometimes you gotta fight fire with fire. I was like, maybe one time you have to fight fire with additional fire. That's ridiculous. It's a fundamentally absurd proposition, okay? If you have a fire, and you want to extinguish the fire, and your best solution is more fire. You just made the problem worse. That's all you did. You're actually a jerk. I think what you want to say is you got to fight fire with water, actually. Or you got to fight fire with anything that's not fire, basically. You basically have to fight fire with non-fire. And he couldn't admit he was wrong. He just kept arguing. So at the end, finally, he goes, yeah, but still. But still? But you're still wrong. But still, if you ever find yourself in a conversation and you're about to say, but still, the correct answer is, I was wrong. I'm sorry. Clearly, I was arguing with me out of position. I'm not only submit to you. You were right. I was wrong. I'm sorry. So the ego came back. So instead, the best said, but still. This happened recently. I was talking to my 9-year-old son. He comes up to me and says, Daddy, can you say this really fast? I said, what? He said, Sally sells seashells by the seashore. I said, I did not say that really fast, but I will tell you this. Sally is a terrible businesswoman. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. Selling seashells at the seashore? They're available for free everywhere. How does she get this business started? That's what I want to know. Sure, a business partner, some investor. I don't have any idea. What is it, Sally? I'm going to sell seashells at the seashore. Get out of my office. It's a ridiculous idea. And he was like, yeah, why are you getting so mad, Daddy? I said, because stuff for other minority business owners. Couple people who are trying to start legitimate companies, get small business loans. She's selling seashells at the seashore. And he was like, yeah, but still. Traveling all the time, flying over here from Chicago. I got to the airport early. And I gotta tell you what, man, they're scaring us all. This is before the Boston Marathon, this is even before 9/11. They've been scaring us in airports for a long time. Have you seen these signs? If you see something, say something. Oh. I get scared every time, but I see a lot of things. I'm not blind. I see people everywhere. Colors, lights, humans, planes. Ah! If you see something, say something. It's really lovely, but I'm standing in security line. I don't know if you have the same feeling. I have the other time, I put my battery on the conveyor belt. My heart starts racing. It's something that's like, oh my God, what's gonna happen now? And then I'm arguing with myself, like, nothing's gonna happen. There's nothing in your bag. Yeah, but still. I get freaked out every single time I go through the thing. I don't trust them, man. I think if there's something in your bag, if you're not looking, then they arrest you. You go to Guantanamo Bay, find out 16 years later, it was a mistake. I'm not trying to be a mistake at the airport, no. So I get freaked out, man. And I'll tell you what, every time I go to the airport now, it's always the same story. I'm walking around staring at people who are staring at me. Have you had this experience before at the airport? You always think like, oh, why am I staring? Well, the thing is, you only notice because you're also staring. You can't see yourself because you're inside yourself. But that's the truth. And the funny thing is, I forget why people are staring because I can't see what they see. Because I'm inside me all the time. So I'm just minding my business, walking down the street, and all those dirty looks are coming in my direction. I'm like, hey, wait, guys, look at that. What's going on over there? Oh, my bad, I forgot you're scared of me. You're like a child of a monster. Ah! Scared because I'm hairy. And I realized people are not just racist or prejudiced. They're actually very curious. They have questions for Muslim people. They never feel like they have an opportunity to ask those questions in a safe environment. So instead they just shout them out randomly in the street. I don't know if this has ever happened to you. I was walking on the sidewalk. This guy was across the street. He said, is it real? Is it real? I mean, what real? Is existence real? I'm not skeptic, yes. No, is it real? I was like, oh no, it's a clip on. It's a clip on, I just learned on the weekends. My own personal favorite question, I get this all the time, but what does it feel like, man? You're rocking that big old beard in civilization. What does it feel like? I'll tell you what it feels like. Mean people look at me and wonder if I might be a terrorist. And nice people look at me and wonder if I pitch for the San Francisco Giants. You gotta know about baseball for that joke. I know we got some of the Moroccans, the North Africans, the older folks in the crowd. I have an international version of that joke, which I will share with you. You guys want to hear it? Mean people look at me and wonder if I might be a terrorist. And nice people look at me and wonder if I play cricket for South Africa. You gotta know about cricket for that joke. Some people didn't get the reference, it's okay. If you didn't get it, you can Google it. Just type South Africa cricket beard, you can laugh tomorrow. Because Google is amazing, can we be honest about that? Google has changed our lives forever. And we don't, my favorite thing about it, such a simple, elegant way.